Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Yu, a video content creator and multimedia designer. In every weekend, I always produce a video to share you guys related to the tool and tip. And I have done so far related to the Zoom. The first video is about how to install and use Zoom as your video conferencing. And second video is about how to use breakout room in Zoom meeting. If you are new for my channel, please consider subscribe my channel. Today, I want to share you guys about how to use Zoom webinar in your Zoom meeting. And let's find out in this video. In order we can start the Zoom webinar, firstly, we sign into your account. In order you have ability to have a setting in the Zoom webinar. So you launch your application that you install in your PC, and you also sign in the web browser. Like I'm signed in Chrome. Here you go to your application. If there is no anything related to the Zoom webinar, you choose more settings in the below this page. And then you will go to the Zoom setting in your browser here. First, if you install or you purchase the Zoom meeting, you have ability to create the meeting. But in webinar, if you are not yet purchased the webinar license, you cannot see in this function at all. So I already purchased the Zoom webinar already. You can check over there about the planning price. Here my organization that we purchased for using Zoom meeting here for 1 year as the current plan. If you want to see the webinar, how we can purchase, we can check over there. It is the plan they provide for us about the price for each. Like basic, we have ability to have 100 attendees to join the meeting, and it costs $400 per year for each license. So here you can increase the amount of attendees based on your need. So in order you can have a meeting with Zoom, please schedule your meeting. Use the webinar section, not the meeting. And then you set a schedule webinar by clicking here. It is the same form as the Zoom meeting you have done so far in the early. Here it is, we record the topic. Like for example, I just the testing webinar. We can two panelists. Like we promote a participant. Participant from attendee to panelists. Here the thing that I am going to test, one is translation. Like we have a button font language and live stream Facebook, YouTube, and third is whiteboard. And you can have ability promote a participant from attendee to panelists, and just testing it. Here's the thing that the webinar is you don't see any meeting ID. Like the Zoom meeting, they have meeting ID that give you. Here they don't have, and they will generate for you. And the passcode you can change by yourself. Like for example, I just typing easy and provide the video, turn on, use the telephone and computer, allow attendee to use toll free based on their call number, no need. Enable practice session, it is enable for you to test it with your attendee and panelists that who joined the meeting. Before the meeting, we are going to start. Here the thing, you enable the language. You can assign the email who as a translator in a meeting. Like here, we can Chinese to English or any language. If you don't have Khmer, you can add it in another section. If you don't see the Khmer language over there, you can change it in another section to add more language. I will show you if you don't have it. So here the thing, if you don't have the email yet, you can uncheck it, close it, and then just add it enable for you. Or you can assign them during the meeting hosting. Okay, here the thing, we can already done the schedule. And just moment about the language, that you don't have any language appear in the part that you select the language. Here the thing that I want to show you, for example, in my language Cambodia, my language don't have it. We just see in here only 9 languages. So here the thing, we can create more language. Like for me, I want to add my language. You can add over there, and then they will appear to here. So if they are missing the label or button over there, you can add more language as you can. There are many settings over there related to your meeting, breakout room or webinar Q&A. You just enable them. Language you can add like this. And here, if you don't check it, you need to check it for your live stream. And then if you want to live through the Facebook, you have to tick it. This part is allow you to live stream through your social media. That's why you need to enable the function and check all the things that you want to. And the custom live stream, you can custom your account over there. But I don't have and I don't use it, so I'm not yet do this. So just uncheck it, and then you can save. So now we can, in order I can record my voice, I use this function. When we start the Zoom webinar, we have ability to assign the Zoom webinar category the two kind of participants. In order they, as you may see, the panelist who is the speaker or who is a moderator that talk in the meeting to share the presentation or answer to the question from the attendee. That's why when you are organize the webinar, you move the speaker or moderator to the panelists in order they have the ability to share screen, audio, and video. However, if your participant from anywhere that to join the meeting, they stay in the attendee. This is the thing that webinar they classify in order they can manage the meeting more manageable. And here the button that you can assign interpreter to able translate for the participant. In order to assign the person into the interpreter room, you assign the person to the panelist first, promote them to panelist, and then you can may assign them to add in the interpreter. Like for example, you can type in the person. Here we have two buttons, English and Khmer. So here you can speak Khmer or English, depend on your requirement button. So when you assign the person to choose to have the room as the translator, you click start for testing or start the practice session. So if you are the first participant, you can click here. There have two buttons. One is the translate in Khmer, one is the translate in English. So you can switch here for the translator. If you want to hear Khmer, you speak to Khmer, and if you want to hear English language, you speak to English. Here the mute audio, it is the function that if there are many noise or sound from the outside room from the translator, you can mute the original audio in order to just hear the sound from the translator. But if you want to hear both, you choose this and mute the original audio. Another cool thing that you can like to your Facebook page or Facebook account. And here the function that you can share. So now I test it in live stream in my account in order to share you guys. Here the page that you can see when you live stream, you can see the text that I just typing during my schedule. We have the title and here the description, the same as you posting in Facebook. You have title and description, and here you can choose your page or your own timeline or in your group. So you can choose each one, not all the item that you are. So if I go into to my page, I choose my page. But here, if you are manage many page, there is a problem with your page, because they let you to have the page that you are admin page and your page that you create by your own. Here the problem that Zoom have only one page for you to select. If you are going to have many page, you can see only one. I'm not sure it is the problem from the Zoom or the Facebook. They provide to one page that can only hosting. So it is we'll see any improvement from they both company like Zoom to fix it or Facebook to fix it based on the negotiation. But in group you can see many things. I'm not sure that I can choose many things. But in page, I'm not sure I can choose only one page. It is a have different story. So I just test my page and go to live. So wait a few minutes in order they connect each other. So here the live stream that I'm testing in Zoom. You can see it is the testing in my page that just want to share you guys how the Zoom webinar they can live through the Facebook page. That is just I want to testing. So you can finish your live by stop live stream. And then you can live to your YouTube. You can test yourself. I not have workplace Facebook page. You can test this from your own. And I just go straight to the YouTube for live stream. So you can allow and then let your account allow. Here the thing that we need to read the information, but I see it. They set it as the default, so allow. And now it will be public to your YouTube. User enable live stream on your. So if you are going to live stream, you have to enable. Go to your studio account. And here, live stream. Waiting. They need to verify your account. Here's the thing that you cannot upload video longer than 15 minutes at the custom thumbnail live stream. Here, live stream. When you enable live stream, you create video live, go to live and have already and verify your channel for your stream. Maybe take up to 24 hours. One in the box. So you have to wait until 24 hours in order you have the ability to enable this live stream. So here you have to wait them. But I think it will be work. Like the first video that I have problem with my live stream because I just enable them. And waiting until 24 hours in order they can provide the service for live stream. Another account that can live stream. So now I can find my channel that can enable the live stream feature on my YouTube. In order to live stream your Zoom meeting to the YouTube, you click the more function over there and choose the light on your YouTube channel, and then sign in your account and sign with your brand account. Here the something that waiting that you can see the blue and red here. You can click here. It is just the private. You can check it or public. But I just testing it and use it public. Yes. So let's start it again. They can configure waiting based on the system and internet. Hello everyone. If you want to share your video or any event in your hosting event, you can share them through the social media like YouTube channel in order broadcast more engaged with your audience. So the YouTube channel provide you 15 minutes to share live stream. It is limit, but if you going to live hour and hour, you can live through the Facebook. You can live 2 or 3 hours based on your meeting. Anyway, if you want to live stream on YouTube, you can do like this. So I just testing this and I will end my video for a few minutes and just say hello everyone that you are watching my channel, and thank you guys.